Ladies and gentlemen, welcome in to the Maelstrom. Good to see everybody. How's everybody doing this fine afternoon? Wanted to take a quick moment to note the crowning of a new bit boss. All hail the new bit boss, Krokvar. Krok, much appreciated. Thank you for the 370 bits stealing the bit throne. Please be sure to take care of yourself first and foremost. My dude, you have been exceedingly generous over the last couple days, and I want to make sure that you're taking care of yourself, my dude. How y'all doing in the Maelstrom Discord as well? I am joined by two Chuckle Fucks in the Maelstrom Discord in the public streaming section for a change. We're not in the commentary booth.
Oh, my.
Squinto, thank you for your tier 1 at 50 months. Hot damn. And Calypso Callie saying, can't believe that this is how Croquet got smited by God. Oh, hell yeah. Hex and Croc, that sounds amazing. So, I've been messing with 2K23, and I think I found out why everybody's themes have been messed up like they have been. So I took a while, and I think I may have just gotten a lot of people's entrances taken care of. Hopefully. Fingers crossed. I don't fucking know. But that being said, I think it's about time for some wrestling. Don't y'all think so?
Yeah.
I have been... Hopefully, I've been on the ball. What the fuck is this?
I believe that's what we in the business call an abnormality, Bob.
That's interesting. You see, my friend, I'm getting ahead of things at the moment. Looks like Denny's leading off the charge today. I'm generating a fair number of items at the moment just to try to have a backlog for when the loot goblins come running in. And on top of that, friends, some of you may be aware that we have started posting the VODs onto YouTube. See, I still have to work on some of them because I can hear Osiris's theme, but it's very low. I will have to increase the volume on that entrance. A lot of these matches are randomized, actually, so the game is picking very interesting matches. We got some weird matches up today. And just give everybody a heads up, at the end of this stream, I will be telling everybody what championship the tournament will be going for, and the tournament will start next week. The teams also will be finished selected by the end of the week. Actually, let me take a look and see how the votes are going. Yep, so that one won. Matrix, if you can get me the character, by all means. If the character's uploaded and I can grab it before the tournament starts, absolutely. Thank you. I will check with Arkoff. I believe I sent you, I believe I got you the custom image that you were lacking.
There we go.
Tournament booking is on the team or the deity of the team. Tournament booking is usually a collaborative effort, but each team submits its choices per week. So usually the team selects one person that will be the quote-unquote booker. But in canon, it is the champion of that particular team that is doing it, even though there may be a booker that's booking matches. The great gold one speaks. The golden letters of Binya Binya say, clever cheese. That is all. Blessed be.
I believe Gunny is undefeated at this point, yes.
Unfortunately,
I could be wrong.
Unfortunately, this is all preseason.
Yeah. Yes. Lost the first match against Crocvar. Fair enough.
This is an interesting one.
This is a ridiculous one.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
I believe that these are characters that have been made, but they haven't seen play yet.
I think the only one I haven't seen is Hilbo. No way, I've seen Hilbo.
Unless they started play in a different region and I wasn't aware of it.
Oh, for the game, no, they... Hilbo and the Satyr are not active as far as I know.
Mm-hmm. Understandable. Yeah, I understand life being busy as it is. JC, Zacko, and I are exceedingly busy. Thankfully, that's why we made the arena, so that people, even though the RDMs are stupid busy, people can still roleplay with each other. Remember when Season 1 was all roleplay, with a sprinkling of combat?
And suddenly death, right at the end.
Mm-hmm. A lot of death. Huzzah! It fucking works! His theme works now.
Beautiful.
I swear to God, if Howler's theme is still broken.
Do you hear that in the distance? I hear the quiet chanting of Praised Be the Sun.
Deus Vult.
Deus Vult.
Solomon coming out in a sweat, in a sweatshirt and sweatpants to wrestle. I dig the casual look.
Yeah. It looks great. Squinto, I have a question. Judgment comes for the what? Wait, is the arena just one giant case of, I thought you were bigger in real life? At some point in time, there's going to be 9 foot tall Minotaur coming into the ring, and he's only going to be 6 foot. Going to confuse everyone.
Oh, yes, the mini tour.
Yes. Compacted by the magics of the arena. Which, yeah, no, we actually had that last season. With the Minotaur, because Uth was 8.5 foot tall, and I think he capped out at 7 foot. The Soul Man is eating the competition.
I've noticed that more and more competitors have horns, and a lot of them use headbutts. We might have to take a look into this. Then again, you are able to grab them by the horns.
Yes.
Wow. Gooslar does have a lot of headbutts.
Yes. I mean, Goosler is also the stereotypical ram. What's that here? Usually they would be matrix, however, due to the magics of the arena, impact of horns has been mitigated to the equivalent of an open hand slap.
Ooh, there's an idea.
Yeah, what Callie said?
Uh-huh.
If someone said, but you climb them with pile drivers, see how effective their head is versus the earth.
Man, Solomon does not want that tag.
I mean, he is a large man and he is a barbarian. If he can't do it himself, he's going to go out the old-fashioned way. And we have blood!
Solomon's a barbarian?
Yes.
Huh.
Yes.
Ah, Zealot. I gotcha.
Hey, Caliban! Thanks for raiding with a party of 9.
How's it going, Caliban? Damn, Caliban with 57 monks. Hot damn. It has been a very long time.
I do enjoy that the holy man is not the holy man, and the demon is in fact the holy man.
Mm-hmm.
A good save by Varish.
Indeed. Damn, with the ref's back turned, Columbo is just rocking Vesrish.
Hello, Vegeta. Is the no audio a choice or is that an issue? He says using audio like a dumbass. It is a choice. Speaking of, I'm surprised Solomon finally went for the tag.
Mm-hmm. I still need to do that offline run of Pacific Drive to get the off-road tires.
The off-road tires will be a good upgrade.
Mm-hmm.
I've never had that reaction. Thank you, people. It's good. I'll eat it later. Not right now. So one of the kobolds just gave me sesame brittle. And boy howdy is it sticky. It's delicious though.
I see that we just don't give a fuck anymore.
Very so. If you're gonna take my partner, I'll take yours.
Man, we got some real heel action going on today, don't we?
Ooh, into the ring.
This match is
the hot shot.
This match is just chaos. I love it. Man, everybody catching hands today.
And a kick out.
I believe, sticking with tradition, this match may be chaos, but I don't think anyone on any of the in the match is on the Team Chaos.
Solomon with the save. Oh.
Oh. It might be also because I'm live streaming to the Discord call as well.
Yeah. That'll usually cause a bit of a chug. We have more blood.
And another big Uranagi from Bilbo.
Technically, they've already their characters are made, so they would get paid for the appearances.
Oh, very frightened back.
A good idea, Gingy.
This old man realizing he's on camera.
Might have been Varish's one shot.
I don't know. Solomon's currently in control outside of the ring, if he can get back in. And your winners, Hilbo Taggins and Cooper Columbo.
Solomon did a number to him, though.
Oh, yeah, no.
And while we wait for the next match load, we'll be right back after our word from our sponsors. And I get a follow during the ad break. What the fuck?
Beautiful.
Roman Nightlove, thank you for the follow. Welcome to chat. Happy to have you.
Well, hi, Mark.
Tonight's show is brought to you in part by the number one energy drink and meal replacement, Dragon's Feast, in over 1,000 flavors from Gondarian Ruby to Sweet Iced Tea. It's sure to satisfy. I did it, Alchemy and Catering product.
And now available at the local convenience store.
I'm happy that you're happy, Joe. I fixed Ash's music too.
Glorious. Is that just becoming a running gag now?
What's that?
Oh, Burb's gonna die.
Probably. Again.
But will he get bonked by the chair again?
Speaking of laughing, I need to go back and grab that clip that someone made for me last night. I was fighting bots with the Landis brothers, right? And I throw a 500 kg at some bots about, you know, 30 yards in front of me, 40 yards in front of me.
Did you look at the explosion, Bob?
The bomb dropped in about 5 feet from me.
Were you looking at it?
I was looking at it.
Ah.
I turned. I was hiding behind a barrier. I see it come in from my left, and it slams to the ground like 5 feet from me. I look at it and say, oh, explosion.
It can only have gone well from there, Bob. The important question, though, is did you live?
No.
My condolences. I'll meet you at your funeral next week.
It was a 500 kg 5 feet from me.
Did you say crap baskets?
No, I said uh-oh.
Is it just me, or does in this light, Kyle looks like he's a follower of Necrom?
That's because it's purple light. Speaking of Necrom, Warzone's coming back on. Warzone is back on Monday.
Yes.
Woo!
I made a promo. Rare thing for me.
And if you haven't seen Shonen Spirit, you need to, because somebody with a bear wife came the fuck back.
And the question is this the standard one, or is this in fact the one with the bear wife?
Bear wife?
Did you see Shonen Spirit, Squinto?
No, I did not.
Do you plan to see it?
I might try to catch up on it.
I did in fact see it, yes, Bob.
I'm just trying to think to myself, who has a bear wife?
Fuck you, bear wife is canon.
And we have blood. I mean, to be fair, it was a dwarf. Can you truly classify a female dwarf as a bear? Because if so, that opens up a whole list of slang terms.
That entire relationship is a menage fucked up.
And your winner, Howler! Well, he didn't die.
What do you expect? Carl doesn't have his gun.
The face of nothing but gold.
I love gold!
Speak enough.
Let me go ahead and just write this down.
I mean, that's part of the reason why I'm announcing the winner at the end of the match, Bob. Lend a hand. Hello, Vegeta. Welcome home. Goosler has been waiting for you.
And 7 is
there is exactly one normal person in that match, Bob.
Don't tell me falsehoods. Nobody's normal in that match.
A normal looking person, if I must.
Well, there's that fine gentleman with the face covering. He seems to be an upstanding citizen.
Oh, yes.
Hig is a perfectly upstanding citizen as long as he's outside of town.
You'll notice that tonight there's a common theme. Most people who are booked has fucking problems with their music that I have to check and make sure that they actually work.
Perfect.
It works.
So it does. Arcleon, I would define normal, however, it would immediately exclude me.
Normal is just a matter of perspective, really. I mean, what is normal for the spider is chaos for the fly.
Yes. I remember watching that episode of Adam's Family. It is a delightful episode.
Mm-hmm. Okay, real talk.
Eh?
Who's seen the trailer for the new Beetlejuice movie?
I saw it posted. I never watched it.
I know that there has been rumor that it's been coming out, but I never caught wind that they were actually making it.
I mean, I saw, oh god, what was her name? The first one.
Winona Ryder?
Yeah, Winona Ryder's character. Then I saw that Ortega's in it.
Yep. So, Winona Ryder is playing Lydia.
There you go, that's the name I couldn't
think of. Michael Keaton is playing Beetlejuice. And the, and
Jenny Ortega is playing Jenny Ortega.
Uh-huh.
I swear, they just like, there, go. Like, here's your costume, just do whatever.
Here's your costume, there's no script, have fun.
What? I legit thought that Jenny Ortega was just, was Lydia for the longest time during that movie before I realized, oh wait, Lydia's older in this movie.
Somebody said headbutts and Goose-Lar came.
I remember the Beetlejuice cartoon. That was excellent.
Mm-hmm.
The 90s had a lot of weird cartoons, didn't it?
The nostalgia of that cartoon.
The Men in Black cartoon. Which was sick. That intro for that cartoon was amazing.
All the furry bait that came out of Disney in the 90s.
Everybody wants to be a cat. There is one movie that came out in the late 90s that I remember vividly because there was a malfunction in the theater partway through the movie.
Uh-huh.
And that is Oliver and Company.
I was about to say, I like that movie.
Oliver, mostly more animal-focused cartoons in the 90s were good.
We're back, A Dinosaur Story.
Oh, yeah, no. We're Back has some trauma bait in it.
Mm-hmm. Dude, the Secrets of NIMH fucked me up when I was a kid.
Now, you see, I was never bothered by the Secrets of NIMH was one of my favorite cartoons growing up.
Specifically the owl scenes.
Yeah.
Like the ancient fucking owl.
Yeah.
I mean, technically, if you really want to think about it, The Lion King was disturbing as shit. With how they got rid of Mufasa.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. Mufasa yotened the wildebeests on screen, and then Scar eaten by hyenas off screen.
I mean, it's pretty fucking metal, I'm not gonna lie.
Yeah.
You see, but that's the thing. You can learn a lot of lessons from Disney cartoons. Like, Scar manipulated and lied to the hyenas to gain power, and when they realized that he manipulated and lied to them the entire time, they fucking ate his ass. And not in a fun
way. That's the problem. He literally gave everyone he promised everything he promised, which is why everything's fucked up by the end of it.
Mm-hmm.
And then if you want
Wasn't
to go
that
real...
the lesson from Bruce Almighty as well?
Yeah, he said yes to every single wish, and all the people that wanted to win the lottery got like $5.14.
Yeah.
Like, hell, then you, later on for DreamWorks, you had Toy Story 3 that was fucking uber dark throughout the whole movie, because it was all based off old prison movies.
You know, I haven't seen Toy Story 3 yet.
Oh, it's wonderful.
3 was the one with the prospector, right?
No, that was 2. 3 is with Lotso the Bear in the kindergarten, where Andy's an adult.
Okay.
Where Toy Story should have ended, and then they decided to make 4.
Because they like money.
It's like Mr. Krabs. Am I going to defile this grave for money? Of course I am.
Did they ever talk about what happened after Sid grew up in the Toy Story series?
He became a trash collector.
Yeah.
He's actually shown on screen at one point in time.
Huh.
Wasn't there a theory about what happened to him based on the fact that there was a character that had the same shirt?
Yeah, that's the theory, that he's the trash man you see in the movies. Because remember, Why would you tell me this? At the end of the first movie, they moved away, so...
I haven't watched a legitimate movie in so fucking long.
And your winner, the Goosler.
On a different server, we've been watching Scooby-Doo movies and then putting them into a tier list. And this next Friday should be the last, should complete it.
All right, I gotta know where to put Witch's Ghost.
I'd have to look at the thing. I believe it's S tier.
Makes sense.
I'd have to. Callie might know where that chart is if Zericus had posted one.
I have pulled some bullshit with references from Witch's Ghost.
I've been informed that I reference things randomly, which is great, because I don't even realize I'm referencing them. One of these days, he's going to miss that jump.
Who the fuck do you think he is, Sin Cara? I fucking wish that could be a thing. For you to occasionally botch an entrance.
Oh, it would be amazing. Croc did an amazing job at mangling that head for Grung.
Mm-hmm.
I was going to say, Mark's music isn't working, but it's just low.
Yeah.
It has a long lead-in.
There we go. It's louder.
This is Zacko's character, isn't it?
Uh-huh.
Yes.
I forgot that he was playing a werewolf cowboy.
He's over at the Fairview Dungeon with Colony and Van Theo.
Ah.
They got about halfway in before they got their asses beat and they had to retreat.
Yes, Van Theo, the guy who looks like part Sephiroth and part, was it Edgeworth from Ace Attorney?
Oh, Van Theo is putting the moves on the head of the dungeon camp at the moment. A red hair
seems to be a bit.
Go ahead.
So I was going to say that seems to be a bit of a theme, is having dungeons that can basically kick you ass and force you to retreat.
Funny that.
But as you were saying, Bob?
The head of the dungeon camp, the dungeon explorers camp, is a red-haired dwarf. And she, as soon as Van Theo showed up, she fucking hit on him hard.
I mean, to be fair, it was either going to be him hitting on her or her hitting on him.
Uh-huh. It's rare, but occasionally I do make rolls to see if NPCs are appreciative of certain characters.
Isn't that right, Gingy?
So the Fairview Dungeon is this interesting location where it is a... Nobody has found the bottom of it yet. They've gone through like 7 or 8 floors of that dungeon, but they just keep finding shit.
Ah, yes. The Fairview Dungeon. But wait, there's more.
Mm-hmm.
It's kind of like the under.
Kinda.
No one found the bottom of that.
Which I'm fucking disappointed for, because I am convinced. I am fucking convinced that I was at the bottom of the under. Because there had to have been a reason why Taka wouldn't let me compete in the under.
I mean, it was either you at the bottom or something that you could do things with, Bob. And we all know what a terrible idea it is to give you things you can do stuff with.
Like, I tried 3 or 4 times to go into the under, and Taka kept saying, nah, man, nah.
Kaiath, you're one to talk with something like that.
What?
Oh, fucking MacGyver ass. Oh, here's some string and a paperclip. I've made a nuclear bomb.
I mean, that is a very specific type of character you're talking about. Fortunately, I'm currently not playing any of them anywhere.
I'm your winner, Marcus Alistair.
Alright, note to self, I need to update Marcus's victory. Animation, victory music.
I think that's the first time Croquet has lost.
Alright, so with the under, it was King Ogre. Then it was Ouroboros. Then it was Aurum and Argentum. Then it was Nargle, correct?
Think so. Yes, Ouroboros. The person I kept saying was Croc's wife.
So, those from season 1 remember Nargle. Nargle is the ultimate heresy tech fuckery from the Murder Cave. Nargle is the culmination of every member of the Murder Cave working together with all of our specialties to make the most lethal character possible. We made him unbeatable. Unbeatable. And we had to nerf him to put him in the under. And thus, he was nerfed going into Maelstrom Season 2. Or Season 1.
Robot, you're the only one who faced Chorus twice.
That's right. You don't mess with Ben's mom.
Hold up. This isn't Ash's music. Fuck.
At least it's working, though. Oh, no. Kelly's saying this is Asher's music.
No, it is. It's been adjusted.
Yeah, Alpha, you're thinking of Apex on Flashbang.
Right, because his old theme was Tommaso Ciampa.
Full credit to Gingy. Ash is an absolute brute.
Yes, Ash. You think you've got somebody worked out real well, and then Ash just destroys your confidence.
Ah, so what you're saying is the albatross effect.
Yes. His arms aren't what you should worry about, Alpha. I'm sorry, Squidman, but you're going to die.
Greetings and salutations, friend. It would appear that she punched her keyboard.
I mean, it also might be a character gimmick, judging by the name.
Mm-hmm. Could be.
All depends on whether or not they actually respond.
Welcome to the chat, friend. Enjoy yourself. Cause no problems, and we'll be just fine.
And cause problems, and the cannon is loaded and prepared for anyone available.
I see that we have the first grab bag redemption.
And your winner, Ashnazig.
A fucking monster.
Anonymous Gifter, thank you for gifting a tier one sub to Ashy.
Sounds like he might have to fix his victory music.
Yep. That's why we're doing these testings before the tournament starts. Fix Ash's victory music.
We're on the last match there, Travis.
That's okay, Travis. There's a vlog for everybody to watch. Also, Vegeta, I hope you enjoy that artifact that might or might not be cursed.
You know what I haven't done yet today?
What's that?
That. That sounds very quiet.
Hey, KM. You found this one in the valley.
It sounds loud to me. Might need to be boosted a little bit, but...
You Now, you got a couple choices on that. You can either find that one from the valley, or two, you can find it randomly in your bag, which Croquet has put into your bag at some point. That's an interesting item. I will make a note of that.
Wait, the box head.
You know, I'm willing to bet that I updated it, but for some reason it just didn't update properly. Try it again, Kaya.
Did you see that? No. There we go.
I had to turn the bot on.
Everybody do the flop.
Hold up, let me check something.
Thank you.
Get shield, fuck boy.
Oh, are we showing Joe Mojo? The,
Shield Joe Mojo.
I have a feeling this is going to be a long match for some reason, Bob.
What? No. Squid, thank you for getting a tier 1 sub to Joe.
Also, I would like to take amusement in Yig has fought literally everyone now. In this match, that is.
Let me see if this works.
I think there was a typo in there, Bob.
There was. Ah.
I was gonna laugh if that actually shouted out somebody who had that name. Oh no. Get bitted, nerds.
Oh shit. I done got bitted by Gingy. Gingy, I sure hope you're taking care of yourself first and foremost, my dude. Oh shit. Now Kaya's with a
hashtag get bit.
Now Kaya with a 1,000 bits. Fuck. Don't bit me, bro. You know what? You're making me do it.
What are we doing, Bob? You can't cut me out. That's illegal.
Gee, Bob, what are we gonna do tonight?
Twitch won't let me do it. Twitch is Twitch is cursed.
I told you it's illegal.
I can't do it right now. I have to wait a minute.
Oh no, Twitch won't let you rule the world.
No. Croc.
Get bitted.
Don't you see, do it.
See, I can donate and stuff without getting shield because I have nothing to shield.
Ah, fuck. Joe, thank you for getting a tier 1 sub to get love underscore. Croc, thank you for the 400 bits and... Ah, shit, you fuckers have started a hype train. What the fuck? No. Cease.
Hashtag get load.
I'm supposed to be get love.
Oh, no, I'm gonna get load. But why?
Get load, get load, get load, get load. To the window.
Rocker, right. Thank you for the pre-tier 1 sub. To Nefario Zero, Cam Mouse. Sorry, Cam Lone Mouse Wolf, and Typhi.
You've all done it. I'm shouting out Mr. Touchems.
Not Mr. Touchems.
That just changes the tag from get bit to get touched.
I'm just waiting for what Bob pulls out this year, this season, to traumify us with.
Yes, Joe, that is a fucking name on Twitch. Grizzly fucking made it.
I will say, I love how if anybody else has a show and somebody uses Italian Patriot, everybody who's been a part of Maelstrom goes, wait, what the fuck? Hold on. No.
Thank you, Coco Bellarose, for giving a tier 1 gift sub to Mr. Touchem.
Croc, thank you for getting the 3 tier 1 subs to Masaryu, KM Lone Mouse Wolf, and T3B.
pumps, shotgun, asterisk, no clowns. None of that.
I'm excited to inform you that we are currently 77% of the way to a level 3 hype train.
Calypso, thank you for getting the tier 1 sub to Mr. Touchins. And Rosa, thank you for the 100 hits. Please make sure that you're all taking care of yourselves first and foremost before anything. Most importantly. Oh, I'll be sure to thank Grizzly, blame Grizzly, when I anonymously get the sub to a certain D&D stream.
Thank you, Codename Chaz, for giving a tier 1 gift sub to Send in the Clown.
Chaz, why? Why? What is wrong with all of you?
Crockfar,
thank you for giving a tier 1 gift sub to Mr. Crusher. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm pleased to announce we are currently at a tier 3 hype train.
You know what? Let's see. It's not the clown. Oh, we're gonna cause chaos today. I'm just gonna. We're gonna get some notice because I'm shouting random people out right now.
And your winner, Francisco Cuye.
Squinto, why?
You, Mr. Smash'em.
Joe, why?
Thank you, Joe Mojo, for the tier 1 gift sub to Mr. Smash'em.
Oh no, Willie!
Thank you, Willie, for the redacted.
Willie, why?
Question isn't why, it's why not.
Okay, the reason why I got it right is because I can actually do the French.
Willie,
you're an honorable gifter for the tier 1 gift sub to Bussy Queen.
Willie tempting people with the forbidden fruit.
Why are all of you like this?
Thank you for the tier 1 gift sub to Plus Master Crawford.
Why? Why?
Because we're almost halfway to a level 4 hype train, Bob.
Oh no.
Oh, is this the eternal match for the day, Bob?
Willie's got a goose doing the dab. Or no, the gritty. There we go.
Ah, yes, the gritty goose. I don't think that Grizzly has made clowns for 24 yet. I could always be wrong, but... Oh, sorry, 23. Wait, no, the clowns do exist for 23 because they were on the show last year.
What the fuck is wrong with half of you? I know what's wrong with the rest of you.
Oh good, you know what's wrong with me. Even my therapist couldn't figure that out. Darkbar, thank you for the tier 1 gift sub to Chaos Champ.
Now, we don't have to do this, y'all. You know, we can just... let the hype train die, focus on the match, which is in an empty arena that nobody knows where the fuck we are.
Oh, I recognize this arena. Oh. It's one of the grand arenas in Barathaim. Also, good night, Gingy.
Rest well, dude.
Night, Gingy.
Sure, those were fireworks.
Willie, I don't have to shower, but I do it anyway.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you ever so kindly for your donation. Remember, take care of yourself first, and thank you ever so kindly for your support for Bob. We managed to get halfway through a hype train level 3.
Remember, Bob, get loved.
Fuck you.
Aww.
With all the love that I can say. In all honesty, y'all, I want to say I deeply appreciate every single one of y'all for everything that you do for me. But I want to make sure that all of you know to please take care of yourselves first and foremost. The last thing I want is to worry that some of you might be hurting yourselves by donating to myself or to anybody else on the internet. And I'm always going to say it, no matter what. Also, Squinto, I hope you realize that I was messing around with you.
Oh,
yeah,
not serious. No, I'm fucking around.
Good.
I got Sean with that before, and Sean's like, "No, I'm sorry."
You're a fucking troll. I get it.
But that was before Sean got to know me a little bit. So, So, in all fairness, he had the appropriate response.
Weaponized emotions. It's a bitch. Ah, here comes Howler again.
This feels like an anarchy in the arena. In front of the actual fans Jacksonville Jaguars actually have. Amazing.
You know what? I will cause some fucking chaos. Robot, are you still here, my dude?
Okay. I do see his name in chat, but I haven't seen him reply yet.
Here's what I need. I need somebody to go to Burnout Vaughn's channel and just lurk. I'm about to do something in a minute or two, and I want to see if he has a reaction. Already there? Awesome. Robot, let me know if he has a reaction to this. Because if memory serves right, he should see it on his Streamlabs OBS. He should see it on his dashboard.
Yes, it does pop up at some point in time. Yeah, Aura.
Interesting effect. Because here's the thing, if I can just ping somebody while I'm streaming and they're streaming, I can just start fucking with people that way.
Bob, you're just giving me less reason to stream at this point.
Then you better not stream while I'm streaming.
The piracy, hey.
Hey robot, any reaction?
The Froge.
Shame.
It might just be in his creator dashboard and not in his main account.
Yeah, most likely.
Battle Royal.
I can hear Osiris's music better this time.
Because there's no crowd.
Go. Considering there's no crowd, that one ghost is very talkative.
That could just be, Rumpy.
Could be.
If you want a reaction, I could just share the pizza. Oh no, Will.
Interesting. You know, I just had a thought.
Oh.
Start a stream. During setup mode, run 3 minutes of ads. That'll stop pre-roll for an hour. End of stream, after raid everybody, run another 3 minutes of ads. That's that'll cover like 2 hours worth and get the metrics up while still inconveniencing nobody.
Yes.
I'm trying to think of ways to mess with the system, cause chaos. Willie, it does accumulate. Because what it does, it counts how many hours you stream, and then it takes into account how many ads you've run. Like right now, across April, yeah, I believe it does count whenever you run, like, ads and stuff.
This is a very brightly lit ring.
It is.
There's been no change in the glow from Howler's armor.
Alpha with a trinket grab bag. See, that was last one was. Oh shit! Oh, I feel so bad.
What?
Thorn's group is a group of pirates, right?
Yes.
Thorn just found a treasure map.
I mean, dandelion leaf tea is delicious. I mean, dandelion root is a great addition to most salads.
Mm-hmm.
In fact, a very popular drink for a long time was dandelion and burdock.
Ontario. Oh God.
Very quick question, Squinto. Which god?
The one that's most beneficial at the moment.
When the fuck did I have 500 viewers at the same time? Must have been during an Unexpectables raid.
Possibly. I mean, there was the one day where three different people raided India.
I'm looking at my achievements.
Bob, I'm going to DM you a question for you to look into after stream, if that's okay.
Yeah, it's perfectly acceptable, my friend.
We have blood.
So, Willie, to answer your question, yes, it does calculate everything. Like, last month, I started messing with it a little bit, and it says that in total I had 13 seconds of ad time per hour, whereas with May, I've been doing it a little bit more, and I have been, it's been bumped up to 23 seconds per hour.
Which isn't bad.
Yeah, but you need like 3 minutes of ad time per hour in order to trigger that thing.
And I believe that is Croquet bleeding now.
Oh, that was Callie.
Yes. Callie's bounced over to my server because we're supposed to have D&D at some point tonight.
I'm going to bounce as well, because I'm going to get some water first.
Have yourself a good one, my dude.
Have fun.
Have a good night. And I'll see you later, Keith.
Have you grabbed that trinket bag for Matrix yet?
I literally just did it.
Beautiful.
And Varish is eliminated.
I will check on that.
Why did you walk to Mishka?
Yeah. Mishka is the one to eliminate in this match.
Oh, there goes Terriel.
Wow, we're getting cursed in chat today, I see.
Are you telling me I should grab another item, Bob?
I mean, do you want to risk getting the Discord kitten collar?
I've gotten worse before. I've made worse for players before.
Oh god, KM. One for your Discord kitten. Matrix, that collar is for your little pog champ in your life.
Why?
Yig now has a set of five dominoes. Got it.
Just messing with my friends at this point.
Beautiful.
Because I'm curious if they see it while they're streaming.
Perfect. Lionel can give the caller that he just found through the show to Nortia. Because it'll fit anyone.
What is wrong with half of you?
I mean, we're still working on that for some of us, Bob.
Oh, yes, God. KM. Did you just suggest that Nortia is said Discord kitten?
Maybe.
Well, then Nortia better get on the Fortnite.
Good lord, this is just a massacre by Miska.
And your winner.
I am searching for an appropriate response.
Yeah. And your winner for this unsanctioned in the bowels of the liminal space that is arena match, Miska. Ladies and gentlemen, concepts and constructs, creatures and beasts of all kinds. Thank you for joining us on the show tonight.
Kelly, man, all of you stealing the Penguins fanfic.
It was on easy, but now I'm adjusting it to hard.
Beautiful. I am looking for something.
I'll adjust to something else as we need it, but I am looking for somebody to raid.
Who do I have?
Two, three. Come I have on. One, two, three, four, five. I've got six good targets.
I got Vaughn, Tart, Sasquatch Wing.
I have just dropped something into the memes channel in reference to the caller.
Oh, yeah, the tourney announcement.
The tournament will be a tag team tournament for the Solidarity Domain Championship.
Grab your partners by the elbow and throw them round and round. This is going to be a tag team tourney.
Mm-hmm. It was voted via 3 votes on Patreon.com and 5 votes on the Discord in the Patreon section.
I may have voted multiple times. We won't say anything about this, Howard.
So, better hope you got a tag team partner because every team needs to submit teams. And here's the fun part. You can team up with people that are outside of your team, but they have to be willing to team with you.
Beautiful.
Which is going to make things very interesting if the Solidarity Championship is held between two gods.
They will have to hold it in solidarity.
Mm-hmm.
Will they hold hands?
That being said, I want to take a moment and thank each and every single one of you for coming in, hanging out, having fun. Enjoy yourselves. Take care of each other. Take care of yourselves. Thank you so much for your generosity. And we're going to go ahead and we are going to raid Vaughn. I want to thank you all for coming in. Thank you all for goofing off me. But y'all have a good one. And I will see you all next time. Have a good bye.
Oh boy.
Oh boy.